Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Touch Base Tuesday. We're so glad you joined us today, and I want to celebrate today because it is the official beginning of, or say the first day of fall, and it has lifted my spirits. What about you? What a change. Speaking about lifting spirits, that's what I want to talk about today. Is that so many people are in the business of putting people down. But yet I want to talk to you about the word, or the definition of the word lift. And first thing that the word lift means is to move or bring something upward from the ground. Now I want you to pay attention to that. We're going to talk a little bit about that later on. It is to move or bring something upward from the ground. The second part of the word lift means to support a higher position. And then the third thing is to raise or direct upward. One of my favorite scriptures is found in Psalms 40 and 2. He lifted me out of the pit of despair, out of the mud and mire. He set my feet on solid ground and steadied me as I walked along. Isn't that so true for a lot of us that have been born again? That God lifted you out of your sin. He lifted out of your lifestyle and changed you. And now you're walking on the path of right living and holy living. And it is a joy to be able to do so. There is a sad part that I do want to bring to you, but yet there's a silver lining in this. When you go to Psalms chapter 3, it's a very sad passage or chapter when it talks about a son by the name of Absalom that became rebellious and actually run out his daddy out of his palace. And not only did he run King David out of his palace, but he had leaders and generals and counselors of David that turned on him and sided with Absalom. David wrote in Psalms chapter 3 and verse 3, "But thou, O Lord, art a shield for me, my glory and the lifter of my head." David was a man of sorrows. He went through a whole lot, but yet he knew that God always lifted him up, always brought him out of a situation that looked like it was hopeless. And I hope that I'm talking to somebody today. You're in despair. Maybe you're hopeless. Maybe somebody's turned on you. You've been hurt. But I'm telling you what, lift up your eyes. As David also said, he said, "I cried unto the Lord with my voice, and he heard me out of his holy hill." God will hear our prayer when we pray. Also in conclusion, I want to go to Acts chapter 3. Peter and John, they were going up to the temple to pray. And there was a lame man there that was sitting at the gate and to the entrance to the temple. And it was that day, it says, that Peter fastened his eyes upon him when John and said, "Look on us." And then Peter said, "Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I unto thee. In the name of Jesus Christ, rise up and walk." And you remember earlier I told you about the definition of lift, that is to move or bring something upward from the ground. Peter reached out his hand, and the scripture says that he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and his ankle bones received strength. And what I got out of that today when I was studying it was that if we will do our part in lifting somebody up, whether it's an encouraging word or doing something for them, God will come in and step in doing his part. And that's exactly what happened. When he reached out his hand, he said, "I don't have any money and I don't have the ability, but in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk." And the interesting thing about that was in verse number 8, and he leaping up stood and walked and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God, all because somebody had discernment, all because somebody took time to lift somebody up. And I pray that this has lifted you in your spirits today. Now go out today or this week sometimes and lift somebody up. Give them an encouraging word. Take something to them or do something. Maybe make a phone call or text to them. It does make a difference. God bless you, and we'll see you next week.